Previously on Stills.
When I get married. Pete, why is he texting me?
They don't like when their boys lead a game.
I'm pregnant. You betrayed me!
Your father passed the latest.
No.
I need to cut it off with the bod, decide what I want with Joseph, and focus on becoming an adult.
How does January in LA sound to you? My personal visual documentary.
Katie, she's fucking trying to oust you from your business knowledge.
Merry Christmas, pack your shit.
Jamie!
Go!
You've been served.
That cunt.
Growing up, I pretty much had one friend, Brian.
It
was the best friend I ever had. Brian could throw 102 mile an hour fastball. And his AIDS, went through him even faster.
I never told you about Nathan. He was the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen. And that voice. God. That voice. I mean, I fell in love with him at first sight. I think it was because I was young. That's where my nickname came from, Peach. 4 years after being together, he replaced me with this skanky bitch, Patricia.
Patricia, I'm HIV positive, Nathan.
There's nothing wrong with me or Patricia or our baby. She's pregnant.
You gotta test it.
We're both positive. I let Nathan define me. I sulked over what he did for years. I have to discover who I am. I'm sorry, can I help you?
And I'm looking for Maya Perkins.
And they're willing to put forth how much?
$700.
So that puts us a total of
$4,237.
Not the usual tens of thousands of dollars I'm used to having thrown at you.
Welcome to my world. Can we do that for that amount?
No. Yes. So we need other options.
What should we scale back on? You two know the world better than anyone.
Dylan.
Sorry, what?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. So I just zoned out for a second. Sorry.
Well, we have no money, so what do you feel we can scale back on?
These people are used to being wined and dying, so, Rose, what if we could use the big room at Rose's gallery? Spruce it up, like a theme maybe, have hot girls walk around in skimpy baseball jerseys, serving stuff.
Hell yeah! The gallery shouldn't be a problem, but that's gonna change your schedule a little bit. Depending on what's already scheduled, I can talk to Grace.
And you know, having a more hip and bright
community, like a map out of loose. I'm sorry, can I help you?
If you can, I'm looking for Maya Perkins.
Who are you?
Is Maya here or not?
Not. Do you have an appointment, Mr.
Nathan? I used to work here. In fact, this used to be my office.
And now it's my office. Hi, I'm Jessica Alvarez. Do you have an appointment?
I didn't. I just assumed Maya was still working here.
She doesn't. She's dead.
We'll use the gallery. What can we do with $4,200?
That's not even enough to cover booze.
But I have a few friends that own breweries. We could turn them into stocking event.
My cousin owns a bakery. I mean, maybe I can get him to donate some desserts.
It's a baseball thing. Fuck high-end. Serve hot dogs and shit.
That'll be an issue. I went by her place.
What?
Huh?
What did you just say?
We have to put up our best face.
Let's take a break. What do you say?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
There's a family. How long ago?
Long enough to be killed by you. But thankfully not long enough to ever see your fucking face again.
You were a friend of mine.
I was her boyfriend. So you get the fuck out before I take you the fuck out of here.
Mr. Nathan Myers,
If you want to make an appointment, then that's fine. But if you have any other business with Maya, I'm sorry, it's too late.
I see. I apologize for the interruption.
Thank you for calling for a break.
We're doing something important here. We all need to be here.
I wanted to fucking kill him when I saw him.
I know. Believe it or not, I did too.
So why did you go along with it?
You were good to Maya. I didn't want a good man getting arrested for beating up a man with HIV. And I saved the company from bad press.
She's up there in Boston right now with her family fucking healing. She doesn't need him finding her, showing up on her doorstep and fucking all that up.
Remember what I said? He might try to contact her family, you know, to give condolences.
Good.
And her father can come for me.
And she may kill you. That may have been the closure that she needs. What you did, it was honorable. But if she calls and asks me what happened...
You'll tell her what happened, I know.
I know, it sounds mean. It's not your place to protect her anymore. That's not your decision to make.
What are you waiting for? She's late. Lost. Lust. Desire. Unwanted. She's gone.
I got it.
You feel you got it?
Yeah.
Good. Let's see. Did you feel like you had a connection with your subject?
With you? No. I don't think I needed it.
Why not?
Abandonment. The subject is supposed to feel isolated, abandoned. To have a connection with the photographer would just detract from it.
Is this a constant?
With some, yes. Others, no.
Yes.
You're not acting. You're relying more on your feelings and what you're thinking.
Well, this is true.
But?
Are these catalog caliber?
I don't think it is.
So, if I wear what I feel, do I need anyone to coach me into recognizing this?
No.
No. You hate the silence, don't you, DC?
No, I never really thought about it.
I am out here freezing my fine ass off, whereas Max is out here for DC Collins. Now, your typical subject is out here to get paid. And a voice behind the lens serves only to remind the talent that this is a gig. And the gig and the money that comes with it is a far better blanket than any coat. But if the voice is silent, the cold creeps in. The money and the gig fade into the distance. And the isolation is real. Your voice will get you annoyance. Your silence will get you the truth between the poses. That's the abandonment I was looking for.
How about we get a hot chocolate?
Yes.
And do another round.
Okay. Yeah, okay, so to make a long story short, I like men, okay? And yeah, so I might be a little liberated in how I go about doing that. So one morning I have to get up to pee and I find these HIV meds in this guy's bathroom. And you know what? They could have been his roommates, okay? But yeah, fine. I go get tested and I promised my friend that I would see a therapist, so here I am. And I know what you're gonna say, okay? One, I need to be more careful. Yeah, duh. Two, probably you're gonna say that I'm trying to fill the void after my mother's death. Or even the void after not having to take care of my father anymore. But you know what? That's crap, okay? That's crap because I have plenty to worry about, okay? I am being sued wrongful termination by my cunt of an ex-assistant who tried to steal my studio and business out from under me. So excuse me if I like to drink a little bit and have no strings attached fun with men I never have to deal with again, okay? Is that so psychoanalytical worthy? No, no it's not, okay? So you know what? I am sorry for wasting your time, but I'm sure you're not sorry for taking my money. Which reminds me, I need to get a lawyer. Actually, this made me feel better, so thanks.
My flower, we're late.
I know. Veronica.
Yes, Rose?
We're going out for a bit.
Okie dokie, anywhere good?
Yes and no, to pay the florist.
What are you talking about? That's very, very, very good.
Well, maybe if we were not so late.
Hush it. Anyway, are you making dinner for yourself and Bethany?
Well, my mom has Bethany for the night, so... And I'll be just fine.
Okay.
So, are you guys getting dinner too?
We are.
Have fun!
Okay, thank you. What time is Josh supposed to be back?
Well, like, I don't know. He's in his GED class all day, so like, who knows?
Alright, well, give him our best.
All yours.
The rest of the day off. We have the place to ourselves.
Oh, hell yeah.
You wanna grab some dinner before you head home? You wanna catch a movie? I mean, it's been a while since we've done anything like that.
It's okay.
Tell me what's wrong. Did I do something?
No. It's not you, Max.
I'm glad. No. If you want to talk about whatever it is, I'm here.
Hey. Hey, look, I'm gonna walk. And, I need to think.
Okay. I'll call you later.
Time you were it. You were the only guy I was having fun with, the only guy I wanted to have fun with.
It's Joseph, isn't it? Your phone. I see the text messages when you're in the bathroom.
You look.
That's twice, yeah?
No, no. We never said we were gonna be anything.
Didn't mean I didn't care.
Me either, but...
That you met a boy and fell in...
Yeah.
Love Tom Sex. Good for you, Drake. I'm happy for you, man. All right.
Okay. Hi, I'm
Dylan Patrick, Rebecca Locke, ACS.
I did the Ice Bucket Challenge, and I donated.
That's actually pretty funny. I've never heard that joke before.
What joke?
Charming. Administration of Children's Services, or a city agency.
dedicated to the prevention of neglect and abuse of children.
We also find them loving homes.
Yes. Awesome, awesome. Come on in. Come on, that's great.
I didn't realize that any of the ladies started reaching out to agencies yet, right? But that's great. So what can we expect away with city funding?
I think you misunderstand my visit.
You're not here for a league?
I'm unaware of any league.
Some friends of mine and I were starting this all-free little league for underprivileged and at-risk youth. Through the Gay Center down 12th, I thought you were here about that.
That sounds really cool. I definitely want to hear more about that. But I'm actually here for a different reason.
Mm-hmm.
Nathan Myers.
Is he dead yet?
Not yet.
Okay. Come back when he is.
Is Maya dead?
Yep.
Bullshit.
Look, that piece of shit has absolutely no business trying to find her. And I'm going to make damn well sure that he does not.
And we don't need you to find her.
So what's your deal with him?
After you told Nathan Maya had died, he came to ACS. Asked us to look after his son.
So what, he's pawning off his kid now too? Not yet. He's dying. He did look like shit.
You find that funny?
Yeah, pretty much.
His son is about to become an orphan.
I guess Patricia's dead too?
Unfortunately, yeah.
Karma's a bitch! What did he want with Maya anyway? What, to make peace? Alright, so Patricia's gone, he comes looking for Maya, he doesn't find her, then he goes to you. Come on, no. No fucking way!
The only living relative he has is a 94-year-old grandmother who suffers from dementia. She's not fit to raise a kid, and Patricia's family wants nothing to do with them.
So what, he wants Maya to raise the kid he had with the bitch that he... The woman he cheated on her with got HIV from then infected her with it. You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Nope, I'm not.
Alright. So what do I have to do with this, right? You know that I lied to Nathan. You know that Maya's a lie. What
and
do you
I
want?
Have her contact info.
So Nathan knows?
No. Nathan doesn't know. I don't necessarily do things by the books. Nathan is an arrogant little man who handled his personal affairs appallingly. But no matter what his crime is, does his healthy young little son deserve to be punished for it? Don't we all get a second chance? I'm gonna contact Maya, but it would be better coming from you.
What do you want from me?
Allow for the possibility that maybe he's not here to hurt Maya.
Maybe he just wants to say sorry. Most importantly, he wants to look out for his son. Don't believe me? Give me a call. I'll take you to him. You can see for yourself.
Take me to him?
Yeah, he was put into hospice a couple days ago. He's got a couple weeks. You've got 3 days to tell Maya, or I will. It was a pleasure doing business with you. Look, I'm not asking you to sit there on his deathbed and just hear him out. Now, I did a little research on you. You and your friend Brian. Could have easily been you. Brian could have easily given it to some girl. Gosh, we all make mistakes. Even the worst of us deserve a little chance at redemption. Thanks for your time.
Ooh.
Is that all you got, V? I'm just saying, it's been a while. Ready, set, go again. You dig?
Yeah, let's go again then.
Yeah.
But first.
Oh, fuck.
Do you think about what I said?
Yep.
And?
And? I'm thinking about it.
I want it, Josh. And you should want it too.
I do, baby. I really do.
No, so what's your problem?
Let me just finish the semester. And we can do anything and everything you want to do.
You like putting shit off, Josh. Promise me you can put this off.
Promise.
Promise me.
Promise me? All right, now. You trust me? Mm-hmm. Honey, baby? Mm-hmm. All right. All right, you got that set. Let's get it on.
Oh, you will. Okay, I gotta pee.
Oh. What the fuck is the women in having to pee? You gotta pee before sex. You gotta pee after sex.
You probably peed on me while we used to having sex.
You're stupid. I love you.
I know you do.
Rose know what we did.
Please state your name for the record.
Caitlin Bourne.
And what is your association with Miss Jamie Gu?
I worked as Miss Gu's assistant at the Pilates studio she owns from July of 2012 to December of 2013.
Are you currently under Miss Gu's employment?
No, I was terminated.
Can you please elaborate on the circumstances that led to your termination from your position at the Pilates studio?
Well, it was my understanding that rumors began to circulate at the studio that falsely claimed I was in some way trying to undermine Miss Gu's integrity as owner and operator of the studio.
Ms. Bourne, please refrain from addressing the defendant in a familiar manner.
My apologies. In the 18 months that Miss Gu and I worked together, I considered her to be a close friend and confidant. So it's been a bit of an adjustment to see her as anything short of that.
And Ms. Bourne, you believe that your friendship came to an end as a result of the unwarranted slander you endured at the hands of your fellow employees at Ms. Gu's studio, correct?
Yes, that's correct. I do not blame Ms. Gu. She suffered so much heartache this past year, and that's why I was hired in the first place, to help alleviate the everyday pressures of managing the studio, the employees, the finances, etc. Jamie's had to contend with an ill father and her mother's passing and numerous other obstacles. I did everything that I could to help her, from standing in as the unofficial studio manager to simply providing an open ear and a shoulder to cry on.
The picture you are painting would appear to tell that Miss Gu came to rely upon your services, professional and personal.
Yes, that's correct. Which is why I don't understand why she fired me.
I understand why some of the others at the studio might be jealous of my
relationship with Jamie.
Excuse me, Miss Gu.
She trusted me to run her business, and I believe that certain employees who had seniority over myself felt entitled, and thus conspired to tarnish the hard work that I worked so hard to achieve during my time at the studio.
Miscu has asserted that you alone acted against both the better interests of her Miscu and the studio, claiming that she is no longer fit to operate the business. Is this allegation accurate, Miss Bourne?
Absolutely not.
You are so full of shit.
Miss Goo, please.
Please, nothing. Miss Bourne is a fucking liar and she knows full fucking well what she
gotta do.
Counselor, control your
clients.
Jamie.
I respected and admired you, Jamie. I still do. I even came to see her as more than just an employer and a friend. I considered her a mentor. I would never act in a manner that would disrupt the studio or defame Miss Goo. I poured my heart and soul into doing everything I could for Miss Goo, for my fellow employees and our clients. Unfortunately, not everyone valued my efforts and saw fit to create lies. Even more unfortunately, Miss Goo fell victim to those lies, and that resulted in my termination. So I'm filing this lawsuit not only to receive financial compensation, but to receive compensation for defamation of character and emotional distress.
So how fucked am I?
That depends on you. Behave in the courtroom like you did today, and I guarantee you that a jury will have no trouble believing Miss Bourne's story.
It won't happen again.
Make sure you don't. As long as you keep your emotions in check, it's fair game. We'll call in your employees and clients to testify.
Well, that'll be great for business. Fuck! Can't be fucking serious.
Yeah, you know, I know we're both advised not to have any direct contact with one another. However, just about now, I'm sure you're finally realizing what I've known since this whole fiasco started.
And what the fuck is that?
Dragging staff and clientele into the courtroom? It's bad for business. In fact, you know, it's the kind of thing that can make a business go crashing to the ground. Oh, but you know what, honey? You're a survivor. You'll be just fine.
Gonna do?
Look forward to him dying.
You still love her? I mean, it's okay. We all still maintain love for our exes somehow. But I really think you should hear him out. I mean, of course, I'll support whatever decision you make. Glad you came.
I think my girlfriend Emmerich should be wanting to come.
Thank you, Emmerich. It's a pleasure.
Oh, likewise.
He's in there?
Yes, I'll escort you.
I'm good.
You know, I'm here if you need me.
I thought I looked like shit.
Stop. Stop.
Dude,
stop, 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 stop,
dude,
stop, stop.
Dude, yeah. You cannot do that, bro. All the fucking doctors and nurses and all the people that come to see me, give me that fucking... I'm sorry. Look, I told them to tell you so I could have some fucking fun again. Okay? If you cry, I swear to God, I'm gonna have them throw your pussy ass out. Okay? Cool beans.
Cool beans, bro.
Ooh. Oh. Fatty.
Oh, fuck you too very much.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
How's your back doing?
Oh, how does it look?
Mm.
It's fucked.
Yeah.
I can't.
can't work out anymore. I can't bend over anymore. I can't put on my socks or even wipe my ass without being a huge ordeal, you know?
I bet you can still bend Brenda over.
Oh, you know me, my man.
Dude, it's okay, don't worry. Look, no cuts, no bleeding. You're okay, don't worry.
I deserve that.
Damn right you do.
Did Rebecca introduce you to Nate Jr.?
Mm-mm, not yet.
How did she die?
You don't deserve to know that. You don't even deserve to ask about her.
That's why you do.
Motherfucker. Now, Maya said you were a charming son of a bitch, but I gotta say, you almost had me.
It's not bullshit. Maya's gone and you're still protecting her. Something she couldn't do on her own.
She shouldn't have needed protection from someone who put a ring on her finger. And let me tell you something, you piece of shit. Maya was the best thing that ever happened to me, but I would trade everything that she and I had together. Everything. In a second, if it meant she never had to meet your piece of shit ass.
I know you're not going to believe me, but I loved her.
That's why you cheated on her.
Cheated on her because my love for Trisha was greater.
Oh my god, really?
It doesn't excuse what I did.
Yeah.
I just need to tell someone the reason, wrong as it may be.
Well, you have to tell me. Because Maya's not here to be told. Because whatever Patricia had, she gave to you, and then you gave it to Maya. Well, now here we are, right? It's got you. Maybe it always had you. Maybe you gave it to Patricia. Maybe you gave it to Maya. Maybe you got it from some other bitch that you were fucking while you were fucking both of them. We'll never know, right? But it's possible.
I wanted to lay it all out to Maya. You're the next best thing.
Does that go for taking care of your kid, too?
I need to know Nate will be okay when I'm gone.
Well, you better hope that the people at the orphanage dead fucking parents. Rebecca, never the fuck again. I really hope that you're more fine. I get home. If I can do what you let that motherfucker die and you leave me the fuck out of it.
I'll talk to him again.
Yo, when'd you get here? How that baby doing? The baby boy. I thought it was gonna be a girl, man. I put the hand out. Now it's wrong. I'm slacking, yo. Yo, T. Yo, you alright?
What's up?
What's wrong? How you doing?
What's up? I don't like this, yo. Let me get your phone. I'm gonna call your boyfriend or Maya or somebody.
No, I can't talk to them.
Okay. Alright, you gotta talk to somebody, so shoot.
Do you think I killed my father?
What? No, come here.
Hey,
getting pregnant, keeping it from him for months, and ambushing him when I finally told him.
Anything else?
You want more?
Nah. Are you ready for some hashtag truth?
Sure.
Yeah. You killed him. And you got knocked up. By yourself. You also picked the date and the time to tell him. Once again, by yourself. You also told him one-on-one, and not with your man or your sister. And you sure as hell didn't tell your mom when you told him. So, oh wait, that's a whole bunch of bullshit. So yeah, if you killed him, then so did all your conspirators along with you.
He couldn't leave on his own. I'm sure he was a wreck, not being able to come home or see his kids.
I mean, based on everything that you told me, he got himself kicked out, right? That ain't your fault.
Never would have happened had I not gotten pregnant.
Let me tell you something for real. If it was that easy for your mom to kick his ass to the curb, then there's already some trouble there, right? Trust me. So yeah, he flipped out because you were pregnant, and he might have said some not so nice things. But that's life, alright? One thing happens that makes another thing happen, and on and on and all that shit, alright? But you did not give him a heart attack.
I wouldn't speak to him. I never got to say goodbye.
Now, that's something to be down about. But don't blame yourself for something that's not your fault.
Feels like it is.
I know. But you never would have been able to say goodbye. Not at home, not at his brother's crib, not at work or wherever, right? Because you never would have known, right? Like I said, that's something to be down about, but please, don't blame yourself for something that you didn't do. And for any reason, do it for this boy right here. Do me a favor. Call your sister. Or somebody in your family, alright?
Alright, because I'll bet you that you're not the only one that feels this way.
Thank you.
You got it.
So, question, would you mind if I left and you hold down the fort for the night?
So this is why you were being so nice to me?
No.
So trying to sneak out of work early?
No. I gotta take care of something. Cool?
Cool.
All right. Gee, all right, here we go.
Thank you. I think he bitch ass show.
What's good, Pete?
Fuck, Josh, somebody die or something?
Look, Pete, I can't do this anymore.
Do what?
Pete.
Do what? Say what you gotta say, come on.
This. Do this. Be here with you doing, you know.
Dealing drugs? Breaking the law, being bad young men? Hey, what that Trini brother feeling with your head, son? Josh got a sore spot for his brother now? You got something to say?
Look, man, I told you, I came up here, kept my word. Just want to talk to you face to face, man to man.
Alright, well, you got it, we here. Face to face. Me and the Trini loving bitch. Bad J. Josh the family man, right? Josh thinks because his little brother's faggot boyfriend owns some high-class gallery that makes him something. They could take these pretty little girls somewhere far away from this shit. Yo, let me tell you something, Josh. You ain't shit. And Josh ain't going nowhere. That's what I gotta tell you. You heard?
Get the fuck out of my life. Get the fuck out of my family's life. That's what I gotta tell you. You heard?
Bye, Josh.
And he made me feel fucking guilty, like, you know, we'd been together for years or something.
Let me ask you a question. Do you gays get like straight girls do after sex? You know, clingy and shit?
Depends on the type of gay.
What do you mean?
What does a lesbian bring in a second date?
Double-sided dildo.
A U-Haul.
I don't get it.
Point is, gay guys, no.
You do what you have to do, right? I mean, you're in love with Dr. Joe, so the bottom is good. That rhymes. I could be a rapper. I could be Dylan G.
No, not Dylan G. No, no.
As ordered.
We didn't order these.
You didn't have to. Seems like you, handsome gentlemen are in need of a solid flow of liquid loving.
Karen, that should call me handsome.
She called us handsome.
Like, you give a fuck. Look at her.
She's beautiful.
That ass, though.
So, why are we day drinking? Why do you smell? Why didn't you change your clothes?
That's a...
Yeah, the same
rule. It's a long story.
You don't have to talk about it if you don't want to. Listen, I'm gonna go pee, and while I'm there...
I'm not holding it for you.
I don't need you to, I got two hands. You can chat up the bartender, and when I come back, if you want to talk, I'm all ears.
What about Emma?
Bitch. Please, learn to be so okay. Trust me. Just because you're on a diet doesn't mean you can't look at the menu, idiot.
Is that your way of calling me fat, dick?
What an
asshole. So, what's the deal? Mm-hmm. What is it that you don't want to talk to your best friend about?
Oh, you heard all of it?
It's kind of my job.
It's kind of my job, too. I'm also a bartender. I mean, not a... posh, swanky places such as this. Not with my gut, it's more of a sports bar.
Oh, stop it. You know you're gorgeous. You could stand to lose 30 pounds and then you'd be living up to your full potential, like your very dear friend here, who you were clearly hiding something from.
He's DC and I'm Dylan.
Lola.
Pleasure to meet you, Lola.
Pleasure's all mine.
You have one new voice message.
Okay, your voicemail is especially gay. OMG, so I'm sure you're dodging my call because Chuleta's fist and tongue are up your ass simultaneously. Know how I know? You guessed it, it's my gypsy blood. I also know it's that because there's positively, absolutely, uncomfortably no way in shit you'd ever avoid me and this first class plane ticket I have here with your name on it. Ta-ta, chocolate squaw.
Chocolate squaw.
So, let it out.
Okay. So, Mac's girlfriend's ex-boyfriend wants me to sit with him on his deathbed as he dies from a disease that he got from cheating on my ex with this other girl who's now dead, and now he's dying from it, which coincidentally is the same reason why me and her met and then the same reason why she left me.
Holy fuck! What did you just say?
Exactly. Well, let me start by saying I'm healthy. DC and everybody warned me about being with Maya, my ex, because she has HIV, but we're safe.
Okay, but he gave it to her. He, the guy who's dying, gave it to her, who's your ex-girlfriend, Maya.
Yes.
Okay.
Now he wants to make peace or some shit.
Peace with you?
No, with her, but I... Well, she's not available. So...
Maybe. So you must, like, really hate this fucking guy.
A little bit, yeah.
Are you gonna go see him?
I already did, actually, and I walked right out. And now my friend and this annoying and persistent caseworker want me to go back. And I don't know
if I can. You can do it. I mean, I don't think anyone would fucking blame you. I mean, who wants to help a lying, cheating fuckman?
Exactly! Thank you!
So, what would DC say?
I don't know.
Ooh, let's ask him.
What did I miss?
So much!
Lola, DC, DC, Lola, whatever she wants, she gets.
Charmed.
Believe me, the pleasure's all mine. You really have no idea how amazing it is to have you guys in here. I mean, my normal crowd in here is just young financiers. And I'm talking about, like, young. Like, under 25.
Ooh.
I'm
sorry.
He's a pedophile.
Hey, now. You would go to jail.
No, I wouldn't.
I'd be there with you. Oh,
okay.
I could not bail you out.
I'll bail you out. I ain't bailing his ass out. He can stay in there. That's cool. Like it.
Oh, I like where this is going. Don't take a pig out of blood. Just bring him in there. He just has a blast.
Don't give up on my secret.
The girls aren't so bad. We do have this one regular, though, who, she's kind of slept with, I think, everyone who's been in this bar.
Ooh, is she cute?
Calm down.
She's all right, yeah. Just, you don't want none of that. You think you do?
I might.
You don't want none of that. Take heed the warning. Down. You don't want none of that. Promiscuous as she is and everyone else, like, the minute that, like, this bar is empty and I'm alone with these people, everyone sings the same song. Like, you know, I want to be in a relationship. I want to find, like, that one person. I'm like, one, close your legs. Two, how can you be monogamous when you slept with five people in one day? Like, how are you gonna?
How are you
going to be with someone if you don't know their first name? Like, you're clearing four from the roster. That can't be easy.
I like you.
So believe me, you having two handsome, that's you, and refreshingly real fucking, like, patrons is just so, so nice. It's like, you guys really made my day.
Amen. See, I told you we should come to this place. And look what we found. The baddest bitch in the game.
Ooh, yes, girl. Work, bitch. Work.
Yes. I do what I have to do. So, our little Dylan doll needs to make a decision about Maya's ex.
I'm sorry. What?
Yes, girl. Mm-mm.
I need your advice, brother, because I don't have any clue what to do.
Bullshit. Nothing I can say will convince you.
Try.
Was she the most beautiful thing you ever saw when you met her?
Yes.
For me too. From day one, I knew she'd be mine and I'd be hers. It was just a matter of time.
Yes, I know the story. You never had an official first date, you never kissed, you never talked about your feelings, you just called her on a Saturday or whatever it was and proposed to her by putting a ring at the center of your desk, I know.
Yeah. Yes.
So what the fuck happened?
She needed me.
What?
She needed me. She was amazing. Beautiful, loving, attentive, but young, in love with being in love. She needed me.
So what, Patricia didn't?
She did, but it was different.
Was I?
Yes, Peach.
Peach. What you called Maya?
Dick move, babe. Two women, same nickname?
More than two. I had many peaches.
Asshole.
Trish used to say the same. She called me on things Maya never... They needed me in different ways.
But Trisha, she was better?
We were more alike.
From the same town?
Same town.
Similar families.
Alike families.
Outlooks.
Yes. I should have left Maya, but I couldn't.
And you just had to be with Patricia, didn't you?
Yes. I needed them both. I loved them both.
This from the man who didn't want to be needed.
No. Have you ever been needed? Needed by someone who waits on every word?
That's not who Maya is. Was.
Was then. Is now.
So this is your great excuse, Nathan. This is what you absolutely had to get off your chest to her.
It's the truth. I could have continued lying to both of them, but it tore me up. And I wanted to be fair to them. So I made my choice. I thought everyone, including Maya, would eventually be happy.
Yeah, but instead Patricia gave you AIDS and it killed her. And it killed Maya. And now, it's finishing the job. It's going to kill you.
I'm sorry, my love. I had no idea.
Neither did I.
Nathan, when you love someone, you don't cheat on them.
I love my own happiness most. I'm embarrassed and ashamed. And I'm sorry. Sorry to you, to Maya, to Trisha, to God.
You're only saying that because you're about to die.
Yes. If this, all this, had never happened, I wouldn't have cared. I wouldn't have regretted my actions, tried to make amends. I know how low a human being I am.
Ask him.
The last thing I will ever do is leave my boy alone.
I'm sorry about that. He deserves better.
He's healthy.
Yeah.
Feel that? Do you forgive me?
Sit, little girl. When I was psyching myself up to come out to him, I almost didn't. And it wasn't because I was afraid of him rejecting me. I was prepared for that. I had accepted it and I was ready to live with it. But I was terrified that I was gonna give him a heart attack. He was a large man in size, in personality, and in heart. You do yoga. I do now. You made life worth living for him. You weren't what caused his death.
Mac.
Hello, Katie.
And what fucking eats away at my fucking skin is that that stupid pussy bitch is right. Win or lose, my business is fucked.
You don't think your clients will come back?
There are two types of clients I depend on, Drake. The first are the yogis and the Zen Tai Chi feng shui bullshitters who don't want all the negative energy that comes with being dragged through a courtroom.
Who can blame them?
I fucking can't.
And what are the other kind?
What? Oh. God, the other ones are like the stupid Joe Schmo assholes that walk in off the street because their friend's friend recommended that they take a fucking yoga class or some fucking celebrity tweeted about it or some bullshit.
So you're gonna settle, huh?
It's fucking bullshit.
It is.
I'm sorry.
What's the grown-up thing to do? I just want to fuck that bitch up and fuck everything that she loves.
Yes, let's jump her.
Yes!
Yes!
Give that bitch a two-piece and a biscuit.
Oh, anyway, let's, how are you? How are you? What's going on with Max and Sabrina?
Max? Sabrina? All up my ass. And not in a good way. She wants a decision.
And?
I made a decision.
And?
I told Sabrina I'm gonna go out there to LA and hear what she has to say. Yeah, why the fuck not?
Do you forgive me?
Is this your last wish?
Yes.
Where are your phones?
At home. Trying to convince themselves their son ain't a faggot. So, you gonna ask me, bro?
Where'd you get it?
They've got these, like, grief counselors here. And so, they told me it'd be a good idea if I called the people I've slept with. I told them that's too many faces and not enough names.
And even less numbers.
Hell yeah. But, you know, I thought it'd be a good idea, so I Googled and Facebooked. You remember Deanna Thompson? Georgetown Law.
Shit. Yes, I do. I tried the maggots. It was her.
Her page was more like a memorial. Picture of her name on the AIDS quilt. So, yeah. I'm scared dead.
You got nothing to be scared about, bro. It's just fine.
Bullshit, man. That's bullshit.
You want me to call your parents? Maybe now, though.
Why? Do you want to make things worse? Thank you for being here right now.
I love you, brother. There's nowhere else I was going to be in here.
Friend.
Like, I even know what's up with that. Regardless, I'd be here.
I should have been more like you. Loyal.
I tried to hit on her. It could have just been me. Should have been me.
I fucked up.
You didn't. Listen, no. No.
I fucked up. God's going to punish me.
God's not going to punish you. Shut up, alright? You're a good person. You're the better of the two of us. God's not going to punish you. God's... Brian.
Jillian, please forgive me.